Top 5 Best Metal Guitar for Beginners. Number 5. Epiphone SG Special. My review, the SG series always meant one thing. Loud rock music. It has been seen in the hands of some of the most legendary guitar players and I came to like it too. If you love the Epiphone SG, the SG Special is no doubt a guitar for you. The really noticeable thing about the guitar was how powerful the sound was, and that is why most people will buy this guitar. It can really hold its ground in hard rock and metal. The Epiphone SG Special is designed to be filled with overdrive and distortion, so don't look for clean and clear sound here. Key specs and features: the Epiphone SG Special is made out of alder and it features the famous double cutaway that gives the guitar its main styling point. All of the hardware on the SG Special is chromed. The chrome look combined with the worn finish gives the guitar an interesting vibe to the body. The neck is D-shape made from hard maple, with a 24.75 inches scale length. The satin finished neck is a bolt-on, fast, and easy to play. It has a rosewood fretboard with 22 frets and pearl dot inlays. The lock tone tune-o-matic bridge serves great and holds intonation nicely. The tail end is completed with a stop bar tailpiece. As for the pickups, it has an open coil Epiphone 700T at the bridge position and an open coil Epiphone 650R at the neck. The pickups are bright with high output, which makes them great for metal. Target customer, entry-level guitarists. If you want to know what to look for, look no more further. This is the guitar that you want, and exactly that you should buy. If you are a beginning guitarist, an intermediate player, or someone who loves to jam out all night long on stage, this is an amazing guitar for the price. Bottom line, sleek design with an attractive finish, it has a timeless look and feel, and it costs under $300. What more do you want? Coming in number 4. ESP LTDEC 256. My review, let me tell you, this guitar is not a high-end guitar, but rest assured because it has the excellent quality, great classic looks and great sound at an affordable price, I've decided to put it on this list. The design is according to my taste. You can see that the designers put the time to combine the vintage looks of Les Paul with the metal vibes. Just the single cutaway body shape is what first caught my attention. The guitar feels and plays so smoothly, and it packs quite a punch. I like the versatility of it. You can easily use it in all aspects of metal and rock music. You can achieve various tones from the pickups and the splitting ability. It has plenty of sustain. It's perfect for heavy metal riffs and even for soloing. Key specs and features: the first thing you'll notice is the resemblance to Les Paul guitars. The ESP LTDEC 256 features a single cutaway design with a solid body build form mahogany with an inflamed maple top that can come in three colors. The neck is also built from solid mahogany and it packs a rosewood fretboard. It has a 24.75 inches scale length. The U-shaped neck is slim and great for fast playing. The fretboard comes with 22 extra jumbo frets that allow great string bending. The overall lightweight of the guitar increases playability a lot. The ESP LTDEC 256 sports two humbucker pickups that are positioned at the neck and at the bridge. Both of the pickups are passive LH150 and are designed by ESP, great for the price. The master tone knob features a coil split with a push-pull mechanism, allowing you to choose single coil tonality to your pickups. The bridge is tune-o-matic and on the other end, it contains chrome die-cast tuners. It holds the intonation really well. Target customer, if you want to shred metal and rock, or even dip your toes into some sweet blues, this is the guitar for you. Great for jamming or doing gigs, it can be useful to beginner to intermediate players. Bottom line, an awesome guitar, with great looks, plenty of sustain, amazing build quality, and adequate pickups. Coming in number 3. Jackson JS-22-7 Dinky. My review, for a low price 7-string guitar, you can squeeze a lot of from this one as it offers a reasonable tonal palette. The Jackson pickups in the JS-22-7 are fairly balanced. Sometimes it can be a little too bright or too brash, but doesn't matter because you are not going to use it to play clean stuff anyway. The guitar resonates really well. It has some nice cleans on the neck pickup, and the bridge pickup can be aggressive just enough when distorted. The tone can get muddy with higher gain, but that's expected from a budget guitar. Key specs and features: the body is made from solid poplar and features an arched top finished in a deep Gothic black with a matte coat. The one-piece neck is made from hard maple, with sturdy bolt-on construction and a reinforced graphite rod, and 24 jumbo frets on the rosewood fretboard. The neck is a nice slim D shape with a relatively flat 16 inches fretboard radius. The double cutaway body shape is quite sleek, and it allows for great access to the highest of frets on the fretboard. It has two passive high-output humbuckers designed by Jackson for 7-string guitars. You can control the tonal variations with a 3-way selector switch, master volume, and tone control. The hardtail bridge keeps the tuning as tight as possible. Target customer: great guitar to have for practice or even if you are transitioning to a 7-string. If you are looking to jump into the 7-string world without spending too much coin, this is the guitar for you. Bottom line, for an affordable 7-string guitar, it sure does have some problem which is expected, but still, it's hard to criticize it because of the build and playability are excellent, making it very suitable for beginner players who don't need something too crazy, a solid guitar that provides massive bang for buck value. This is easily one of the best metal guitars out there for the money. Coming in number 2. Ibanez 6-string solid body. If you are looking for a guitar for a child lower than the age of 10 with small hands, the Ibanez Micro is an excellent choice for players with these requirements. The Ibanez Micro is a pint-sized Ibanez electric guitar at 3/4 scale, ideal for small humans. Although popular with adults, the Micro, in my opinion, is the best first guitar for children under the age of 10 who will benefit from a smaller scale. Most 3/4 scale guitars on offer are typically steel string or nylon acoustic guitars, limiting the amount of choice for aspiring electric beginners. However, the Micro is perfect for young metalheads and rock players who want to bypass the acoustic and learn the electric straight away. A smaller scale guitar makes fretting notes and chords easier for children compared to a full-sized guitar. It must be noted, this guitar also doubles as an excellent travel guitar, taking up less space for transportation than a full-sized guitar. Don't be fooled by the size though, although smaller, the neck includes Ibanez's classic slim profile with smooth maple and a comfortable thin body for excellent playability in typical Ibanez fashion. The Micro includes Ibanez stock Infinity pickups for loud and aggressive distortion and rock. It has to be noted, this guitar has a great tone and resonance for an electric guitar that is small and has less wood than a full-sized guitar. Clean tones are punchy and crisp with plenty of articulation even with stock pickups. Overall, the Micro is an excellent gateway into the world of learning guitar for any young aspiring guitar player. Although the scale is stripped back, Ibanez leaves all the great hardware, looks and features, making this an excellent choice for a beginner's first metal guitar. There are also 3 color choices to choose from, catering to different tastes. In summary, the Ibanez Micro makes the list based on its appeal to young electric metal players at an affordable price, included with Ibanez's build quality and shredder primed metal guitar. Pros: pint-sized guitar for children and young aspiring metal players. Affordable entry-level guitar. The small size makes it great for travel and backup guitar. Cons: small size may not be the best for larger children. Schecter Omen Extreme 6 best overall guitar for a higher budget. Coming in number 1. Epiphone Les Paul Special 2. The Epiphone Les Paul Special 2 black electric guitar is one of the most affordable entry-level Les Paul style guitars on the market. If you're a beginner guitarist or you're a more seasoned player searching for a second or beater guitar, then the Epiphone Les Paul Special 2 has a strong story to tell. This segment of the electric guitar market is highly competitive. There are plenty of choices available with plenty of feature-rich options to match. But despite the level of competition, from predominantly no-name brands, Epiphone still has a stronghold in this area, and for good reason. Body and neck. This is a flat-bodied, solid guitar made from mahogany. Weighing in at close to 10 lbs, it feels substantial. Okay, noticeably lighter than a Gibson Les Paul, but you're still going to feel it. As for the color, we'd honestly have to say that we love it. We think ebony really suits this design and helps to make it look a lot more expensive than it really is. But if black's not your thing, there are other color variants to choose from. At this point, it should be noted that although the guitar we are reviewing here today has a mahogany body and neck, however, the same model of guitar is readily available, constructed from different kinds of woods. Check the specs. If you're thinking of going ahead with buying a Les Paul Special 2, be careful to check the specification sheet first. Make sure that the woods used in manufacturing the specific guitar you're considering meet any criteria you might have. If another wood has been used, though, there's no real need to worry, as regardless of the woods used, it's very unlikely to have any majorly noticeable or significant tonal impact. Although an electric guitar's wood composition will affect its sound to some degree, you're unlikely to notice any major differences. Furthermore, this is likely to be even more the case when using a less expensive guitar through a less expensive amplifier. Moving on to the neck. This is also mahogany, with a rosewood fretboard. It is mated to the body with a bolt-on design. Though a bolt-on neck is not what you'd typically expect to find on a Les Paul style guitar, it doesn't unduly affect the overall aesthetic. The fact is that a bolt-on neck is just one of those compromises you have to accept at this price point. However, although this may have been an exercise in cost containment, there are plenty of high-quality and expensive guitars of alternate designs with bolt-on necks. Another compromise is the plastic nut. Hardly surprising and pretty common on almost all entry-level electric guitars. Oh well. Epiphone Les Paul parts are cheaply and readily available, so easy enough to rectify. Could do with a little finishing. The Les Paul Special 2 has a 12 inches radius and is relatively wide and flat. Not too difficult to get your hands around. Gibson style, this is a 22 fret, short scaled fretboard measuring 24.75 inches, featuring standard dot inlays. We did notice that the fret ends are not as smooth as we would like. They feel a little rough but are in the range of being acceptable. Despite the shortcoming of the fretboard ends, the actual frets and the neck feel nice. If it's a real concern, you can get a local luthier to give it a quick once over. Overall, the Les Paul Special 2 has a feeling of being a well put together and well finished guitar. Good job, Epiphone. Electronics and hardware. Let's get into it with the tuners. These are pretty much what you might expect on this kind of guitar. They're okay but don't look like they're built to last and don't have a quality feel to them. Authentic Gibson tuners come to mind. These are one of the weaker aspects of this guitar. Possibly a future Les Paul Special 2 upgrades project on the horizon for some of you. The guitar comes with a nickel stopper tailpiece and a Loctone Tune-O-Matic bridge. Hardware that you'd very probably expect to see on more expensive guitars. The pickups. These are an Epiphone 650R humbucker at the neck and an Epiphone 700T humbucker at the bridge. These are high output humbuckers. Plenty of oomph in these babies for playing rock or heavier genres of music. Well, that's nice. Yes, indeed, these are a much better quality of pickup than you'd find on most budget guitars. They also sound great. But more of that later. Unlike on a Gibson Les Paul or some of the more expensive Epiphones, there is only one tone and one volume control knob. This is ever so slightly more limiting in terms of the tones the guitar can produce, but if we're honest, 99% of all guitarists keep both tone controls on 10 and only use one volume knob, so no real issues. The three-way toggle switch to change between humbuckers, or a combination of the two, is placed between the volume and rhythm knobs. Now, the switch is familiar enough and looks like any three-way toggle you'd find on a Les Paul, but why place it down there? Sound and playability. As mentioned before, this is a flat-bodied guitar. One of the advantages of this is that when trying to access the higher notes on the fretboard, it's easier to get your hands around than when playing a fatter, rounder, more traditional style of Les Paul. This is a useful feature for anyone picking up the guitar for the first time. The Les Paul Special II's flat body linked with its flat neck profile does make it relatively easy to play and so a good choice for beginners. Great. Before we even plugged it in, we noticed it had a surprisingly loud acoustic resonance. Though this is unlikely to impact on its tone when amplified, it does afford some limited scope to practice unamplified. Yes, we know, and we agree, not ideal. Hopefully, you have either a headphone jack into your amp or live where noise is not an issue. But handy, nevertheless, for those late night practice sessions in your bedroom whilst everyone else is asleep. Super. Okay, so now we're plugged in, how does it sound? Well, pretty good, actually. There's no doubt about it, you definitely get those Les Paul fat, heavy rock sounds from the two humbuckers. The quality of these pickups given the price of the guitar is excellent. They are punchy, warm, and well balanced. And react well to distortion while offering a good amount of sustain. They have all the qualities that you'd expect from a good quality pair of humbuckers. Needs a good amp. Now, to get the most out of the guitar, it really needs to be played through a mid-priced amplifier, or better. If it's played through a cheaper amplifier, most likely bundled together with this type of guitar, it's unlikely to sound anywhere near its best. The good news is, for beginner players, if you start with a more basic amplifier, as you progress, the Les Paul Special II is of good enough quality to continue to accompany you on your musical journey. And for the more seasoned players, looking for an additional budget guitar, the sound quality of the Les Paul Special II should not disappoint. Pros: great Les Paul sound. Easy to play. Solid build quality. Excellent value for money. Cons: only one tone and one volume control. Three-way toggle switch positioning. Fret ends could be smoother.